Biddeford residents say they have had enough of coyotes. Good evening and thanks for joining us. I'm Tracy Sable. Residents say the wild animals are becoming too big of a problem, but a wildlife expert says there are ways to deal with the animals peacefully. News 8's Aly Myles was at a meeting where hundreds of Biddeford residents expressed their concerns over coyotes. And she joins us now live with the latest, Aly.
Yeah, Tracy, these animals have been spotted around the city for months. Residents say some of their pets have gone missing. They're not willing for a child to go missing before the problem is taken care of.
They're not afraid. So we need a better management plan, and that means getting rid of this particular group of coyotes.
Residents in Biddeford say they've tried to live peacefully with the coyotes, but the animals are becoming too desensitized and it's no longer safe.
You're talking about long-term goals, touchy-feely resolutions that we coexist. I don't think the public is in the mood to coexist with their children.
Wildlife expert Jerry Versane spoke in favor of cohabitating with the coyotes and trying hazing methods like making loud noises to live in harmony.
Knowing how to communicate with them. Understanding coyotes' actions and what they are communicating to you.
But residents say animals have already gone missing and they're not willing to wait for worse.
It's frightening. You know, you can't, if you feel like you can't leave your kids in your own yard to play for a little while, it's scary.
The game warden says his number one priority is public safety, and while he'd rather the coyotes live, he has shot one already and will again if he has to.
Public safety in my job is number one, so I can't guarantee that these coyotes aren't going to take it to the next level. I've seen a level of escalation from the first call I've gotten to now, so I can't guarantee that.
The game warden held a meeting in late December where a trapper offered to take care of the animals in an ethical and moral manner. The game warden says, as far as he knows, that trapper hasn't caught anything yet. Reporting live in Biddeford, Aly Myles, News 8.